Good evening, everyone. Welcome to our 2022 spring concert. My name is Corey McHenry, and this is the bottom of my face. We are so excited to be back. We have a wonderful evening of music in store for you. I'm not going to waste any more time. The jazz band is on stage, fresh off of their first place finish at the Clackamas Jazz Festival. We are going to open things up with a tune out of the Count Basie book. This is Hey Burner. You're going to hear solos from Kaisha Barnhill on the piano. Here we go. Russell tune from the 70s. It's been recorded by plenty of folks from Ray Charles to Amy Winehouse to even Whitney Houston did a version of it. The song is entitled A Song for You. We are going to feature Parker Bruni on the tenor saxophone. You'll also hear at the beginning from Kaisho Barnhill one more time on piano. A Song for You. Here we go.
Thank you.
arrangement. We just lost Fred Stern just a couple years ago. He's a prolific jazz composer, writes really interesting music. You know it's a Fred Stern tune when as soon as you hear it. Kind of an interesting little modern. It's got some like little lines and samples that go throughout the entire piece. We've got a great big solo section in the middle. You're going to hear from Parker Bruni one more time. We're also going to hear from Adam Honreiter on guitar. Blake Bruning on the drums is going to offer some of his ideas. This is just a fun, energetic piece to close. This is entitled Chronometry. Thank you.
you guys, you have a few more minutes to buy yourself a raffle ticket. We're doing the first drawing for the first pair of tickets in just a little bit. So remember, the tickets are one ticket for $5. We get a bargain of five tickets for $20. So Sarah's walking around with a bucket right there. You guys have cash. We do take card, personal check, or Apple Pay. So head over there, support your band.
We have the Hawkinson High School Percussion Ensemble on stage now. These folks are fresh off of a performance. Well, gosh, it's been almost a month ago now, wasn't it? Yeah. At the Lower Columbia River Music Educators Association Solo Ensemble Festival, they participated in the percussion ensemble category and took home first place in that division from all the schools in the country. Large percussion ensemble division, and actually taking first place in the small percussion ensemble division was also a Hawkinson High School group, and that is the percussion duet of Kaisha Barnhill and Hayden Buell. So, Kaisha also took first place in the timpani solo division, so he'll be going, him and actually Hayden as well, will be going up to state, the state solo ensemble competition, so congratulations to Kaisha. Yeah. And then Kaisho on multiple percussion, and also Maggie O'Brien, who's down here somewhere on French horn, also plays for solos, which is fantastic. It's a solo ensemble festival. It's all the schools in our area, regardless of size, so it's nice when a little, you know, 600-student Hawkinson High School comes in there and wows them. And wow them, they did. This piece is entitled Valley of Nepal, and we have one student who is out on an illness, and so I'm going to do my best to fill in on that, so.
Yeah.
But, booster table over there for one more chance at your tickets for the benefit dinner, and we'll be right back.
one more before the final band performs tonight. Sarah's going to read the first line. All right, guys. Ticket number 260-4657. Woo, we got a winner up in the top. All right. If you want to come see us over at the table over there after the concert is fine so we can get your info, that'd be great. Thank you.
Alright, thank you for your patience. On stage now, the Hawkinson High School Symphonic Band. We are going to open up their portion of the program with a piece entitled Drums of the Sammies. This is a piece that was commissioned, it's been a couple of years ago. I can't remember how long ago it has been now. But by the Medicine Hat Concert Band of Alberta, Canada. And this is some First Nation Native American music. You'll hear a lot of First Nation drum patterns here at the beginning. The flutes do their best to imitate a traditional wooden flute. It's just a really fun piece that will get your toe tapping all the way through. So we hope you enjoy Drums of the Sammies. Thank you. next tune for the symphonic band is a 19th century spiritual. The piece is entitled When the Stars Began to Fall, but it's based on the spiritual My Lord, What a Morning. And the last line of that tune, When the Stars Began to Fall, is the title of this song. We hope you enjoy. Telling you my experience here. These guys are doing fantastic work. They're mostly underclassmen. How many freshmen do we have in here, by the way? Just hands up here. Right? We have a mix of grades 9 through 12 in here. They're just doing really fantastic work, and I love all of my children equally. I do. I really do. But it's so much fun to get to play with this group and to make music at the level that they're making. It's really apologies to any other symphonic band people who are in the audience, but this is one of the strongest bands I think we've ever had for a symphonic band. And coming off of this strange, you know, 2-year pandemic thing is just a real testament to their work. They're doing a great job. So we have one more tune, but give them a hand. Nothing to say that too, so. But I do accept donations. So, our final tune is a David Holsinger tune entitled "Prairie Dances." This is just a fun, rollicking. Think of like a hoedown, a square dance, a cowboy ballet, if you will. You'll hear the spurs in the background on the tambourine. It'll get you up and dancing all the way through. It burns from the beginning to the end. Great finale piece for them. Hope you enjoy David Holsinger's "Prairie Dances."
call our second winner. And if it's not you, don't worry. There's still time for you to go buy tickets for Benefit Dinner because they are live now. So there's a QR code over there. It's super easy, handy dandy. Open the camera on your phone and you guys can go ahead and buy them. And they are first come, first serve. Tickets are very limited, so I would not wait too long. It's the first one we've had in 2 years, so we expect them to be gone before you know it. Are they shaking? Okay. Get your tickets out. Here we go. All right. The number is 260-4651. Ooh, hey, I see your hand. All right. Congratulations. Just come see us over at the table over there so we can get your info. Thank you, guys.
Right. The ensemble is just about ready. I've got a couple of percussion things we're still moving around. While we're waiting on that, just want to give another big shout out to our wonderful Hawkinson High School Music Booster Club parents for everything they do to support the program. They're super excited because they got to bring refreshments back tonight. So that was like a big deal. Also, very much, we're very excited about kicking off ticket sales tonight for our 13th annual Benefit Dinner Concert and Auction, which is Saturday, May 14th. We hope that you would consider purchasing some tickets, maybe even an entire table, and bringing your friends. We haven't obviously been able to do it for the last 2 years. The last time we did it was 2019, and the event brought in over $60,000 for our event. It's a huge undertaking on their behalf. They pretty much start working on it after the benefit dinner ends. They start working on it for next year. So this has been, like, they've been ready for this for the last 2 years. So we hope that you will attend. Obviously, they've been raffling off tickets, but if you weren't lucky enough to get the raffled ones, there is an insert in your program where you can go. Registration is all online this year. All of the auction stuff will be digital as well. We'll have the items obviously there for you to check out, but we'll be using, you know, technology and everything. If you've been there before, you remember the big checkout line at the end of the night. We're gonna get rid of that this time. So I'm setting lofty goals. So we hope you'll join us on Saturday, May 14th. Tickets are on sale through about the end of April or whenever we reach capacity out there, which happens every single year. So Don't delay, get those tickets. Anyways, now it's time for our final band of the evening, the Hawkinson High School Wind Ensemble. They're gonna open up a tune, which after following Prairie Dances with Symphonic Band, you're gonna hear kind of some similarities actually. Now that I was, as I'm standing there, I'm like, this is kind of like Prairie Dance's big brother. This is entitled Joy by Joseph Curiel, and it's just a fun toe-tapping piece that will, it's joyful. I'm not gonna say anything else. Let's just play, okay? Which is represented by the flute. It's kind of a longing for home kind of piece. There's some traditional Japanese folk songs that are woven in with kind of some more Western harmonies and modalities. And it's just a beautiful piece all the way through the end. Gonna hear, you actually heard Madeline on our harp over here, and Kaisha's gonna be playing that harp part over there on the synthesizer as well. Annabella Horsley on flute, and this is Fantasy on a Japanese Folk Song.
Thank you.
reached our final tune of the evening. Before we play it, I just want to say one more time, thank you for coming out. Thank you for supporting our program. And we hope you've enjoyed the evening. If you like what you heard, they're going to be performing it one more time exactly 1 week from today at the Lower Columbia River Music Educators Association Band Festival. It's the who's who of all the bands in the county, and they will be at Mountain View High School performing for each other, for a panel of judges, and we're very excited to be back for the first time since 2019. So the symphonic band performs at 11 a.m. and the wind ensemble performs it at 2 p.m. I'll send out a live stream link for it too, just in case, but we would love to see you there if you happen to be around Mountain View High School next Tuesday. We are going to end tonight with a piece by kind of a newer composer, Benjamin Taylor. This piece I actually found from our friend of the band, Dr. Patrick Murphy, who is the director of bands at University of Portland. He introduced us to this tune back in 2020, like one of the very last things that we did. So we hosted the North County Honor Band here, and Dr. Murphy played the tune with the North County Honor Band. He actually commissioned the tune, which means that he worked with the composer and kind of paid the composer and stuff to kind of custom write this tune for his college ensemble. And I loved it so much that when we came back, I said, we're gonna play this tune now with the full band. And they've really dug into it. It's not easy music. You're gonna find it kind of sounds like movie music. You're gonna hear, I think when we read it for the first time, somebody said, gosh, that's like Pirates of the Caribbean or something like that. It's very dramatic, has that kind of feel to it. But it's entitled Trailing Clouds of Glory. It's in three movements, and it's based on a poem, which I've included in the program notes, if you want to take a look at that really quick before we play. But it's just, it's exciting music. The second movement's a little bit playful, and then it just really, it really comes alive at the end. So we hope you enjoy Benjamin Taylor's Trailing Clouds of Glory. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.